Hey, this is Huckleberry, and you're listening to the Unbelievers Podcast.
There were several groups. One of the principal ones was the reptilians from the Iran complex.
Without any exaggeration, it was like being on fire inside.
The rats were eating you inside.
This stuff was in my mouth. It felt like it was 500. It was unbelievably hot.
My first question would be, were you a member of the Church of Satan, a card-carrying member of the Church of Satan?
I don't understand.
There's always an argument for everything. Just because somebody can fake something doesn't necessarily mean it's
Warren, we found a life form. And that's when I started shitting my pants.
So for the person who called, I am carrying an alien.
An alien that man, we cover it right here.
Okay.
Something is happening. What is it? That's the question. So do UFOs exist? It depends on what you mean exist.
If you think that goblins are the biggest threat facing the state of Kentucky, okay, that's fine, Diane, we're coming over to tell you the tale of another monster peeking out from behind the bushes of the bluegrass state. Spottsville, Kentucky, 1975. A rural family named the Nunleys moved to a remote farmhouse only to be terrorized by a creature that can only be described as one of the scariest monsters ever. So join us tonight as we decipher the story of Bart Nunley and his family's experience with a beast that defies both reason and explanation. We're talking the Spottsville Monster on this Spooktober episode of the program. We continue to learn to unlearn everything you know. Hello and welcome to the Unbelievers Podcast. I'm your host, Rus Ryan, and joining me tonight is my co-host in California, Drea Mora. Hello, Drea.
Hello, Russell.
And our soundboard engineer and producer on Long Island, Rob Okey.
Hello. Theodore, don't.
What's up, guys? How you doing?
Oh, my God.
What's happening?
Great. That was a good spooky clip to start, because you don't want to talk about it. Now it's October. Is this your guys' favorite month, Drea?
Oh, you know
spooky
it.
Spooky time.
Come on. Of course. The
I
best.
Thought so. My favorite time, too. Weather, everything great. Everything spooky everywhere. But are
everything
you guys...
Everything great.
So are you guys looking forward to doing anything Halloween-related, other than us doing Halloween-type shows?
No, I'd never look forward to Halloween stuff. Of course, we've got a couple parties. I don't know what I'm doing on the actual day of Halloween, because it lands on a Thursday. Probably going to call off work on Friday, so I don't know. Yeah, I'm just going to see what's happening. I don't know.
It sounds more fun than anything I've been up to. What about you, Rob?
I don't know. I'm probably going to try to find something to do. I'm in the middle of, like, moving and stuff, so it's tough for me right now because I don't have a lot of free
spooky.
Time. Yeah, nope. it's super spooky, but I think there's some
You'll
cool...
be in New York, right?
Yeah, I'm going to be in New York. There's some cool
There's
cool,
going to be so much
stuff.
Going on over there.
There's a
there.
Lot of
yeah.
cool stuff going on in New York around Halloween, so I'm sure I'll find something fun to do. I just remembered, next weekend I may go see the music from Stranger Things get performed live in Brooklyn, so that's something cool.
That's
interesting.
That's a cool thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't have cool stuff like that down here, but I want to get to a haunted house. I haven't been to one in a few years. Just a nice...
Oh, they're so fun.
A good, cheesy haunted house. It would be a lot of fun. I'm going to go do
that. I've been in a haunted house before, like one of the people who scares people.
Oh, wow. What were you?
It was an insane asylum themed thing, so I was kind of like a nurse, but like not quite... Like I had the scrubs on or something, you know? It was a lot of fun. Yeah.
Did you jump out and scare people? Like,
Theodore, don't.
Drea, don't.
I kind of wish that I had, but no, I would basically trail people and be like right behind them, like really quiet and creep them out.
That creepy girl's behind us again.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, some girl was like, "Why are you so scary?" And that was the best compliment I ever had, ever in my life.
Well, hopefully people will be saying that about tonight's episode. So let's get into it now, because this is kind of spooky for Spooktober, but we'll be the judge of that. Here it is. The Spottsville Monster.
I think not.
Yeah.
Kentucky Dirty.
Kentucky Dirty Chicken.
What did you just make us listen to?
What the hell was that?
Well, tonight
I'm not a fan of that music.
We're talking about the Spottsville Monster, and Spottsville is in Kentucky. Kentucky Dirty. But yeah, this is October. This is the time when scary things are everywhere. We should be talking about scary things, and I think that there is nothing scarier than monsters, right?
Sure. If you
they're the
say
worst
so.
Monsters.
If you say so. Yeah, look, monsters are defeatable. What I think is scarier is like demons and ghosts. But you know, sure, yeah, monsters are the
well, monsters, monsters can be that too. This monster especially.
I've never seen or heard no monster.
Get out of here. You're not in this.
Nice.
Because look, at first glance, you might be saying, this is just another Bigfoot, but I am not sure about that. This is a really violent, hairy, giant woodland dwelling monster known as the Spottsville Monster of Kentucky. Have you guys heard of this one?
No, actually, never. And okay, now that you say that he's really violent, now I'm scared. So yeah, good job.
Yeah. Well, the Spottsville Monster, this is the true story of various encounters with big, hairy, seemingly supernatural Bigfoot-like monsters and other strange phenomena in the lonely bottomlands of western Kentucky. And tonight, we're going to hear stuff from a very new documentary, at least I think it's new, called The Spottsville Monster. This was just released a couple of weeks ago. Rob, you're going to love this. This thing almost has like 200,000 views. It's only been out for 2 weeks.
Wow.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
I'd never heard of it, and evidently this Spottsville, his spot is blowing up.
He's blowing up, man. Wow. Okay.
And we're going to blow up his Spottsville tonight because we're going to listen to this documentary, and this is the tale of a family called the Nunleys. And the documentary focused mainly on the son, Bart, who is featured heavily in this, and he has also written a book on the monster. So here's our introduction to this monster from Bart Nunley himself.
It's been over 35 years ago, and I remember like it was yesterday. But what I remember most was the fear that we all felt when these things came around.
For Bart Nunley, this is where it all started. His childhood home used to be located right here, just a vacant lot now. But decades later, his family still remembers the terrifying nights they experienced with what is now known as the Spottsville Monster. And those memories haunt them to this day, which is the reason Bart has been on a decades-long search to find the truth.
There were several times that my family saw this creature in broad daylight, but it was usually at night, is just when they would be more active and come up, and they would just come up and rattle our doors and look in our windows, you know, and walk around our house and just scare the hell out of everybody.
Okay, he's peeking at you. That's kind of scary, but this is kind of
pretty
common.
Scary.
It does sound kind of like the old Sasquatch.
Yeah. I guess we'll find out when you said like the almost supernatural Sasquatch. I'm like, well, what defines that? Like, what, he's ghostly too, or has superpowers, or that's.
Well, they sound scared, and it's a very scary situation. And Bart explains why here.
It's just a really scary situation because once it got going, it was almost every night these things would come up and terrorize our family. The reason that we were also scared is no one knew what it was, you know. We didn't have any idea about Bigfoot back then. I was 9 years old, never heard of Bigfoot, and neither had my father.
Yeah, see, it's every night, and they don't even know what Bigfoot is.
Well, I mean, how's he going to say you don't know what Bigfoot is, and then you just referenced Bigfoot, but...
Well, this happened in 1975. I'll say the events that happened to this family happened in 1975. In this house, it's the parents and a bunch of kids living out in Kentucky, in Spottsville. And I want to introduce another member of the family. Okay, we've met Bart Nunley. And here's another firsthand account from my favorite member of the Nunley family, Bart's mother, Marge. No, it's his mother. His mother is Rosalie Jenkins. Let's meet her.
Bart's mother, Rosalie Jenkins, recalls an encounter that happened one night when her daughter-in-law was getting her grandkids from their house trailer next door.
We had this big dusk to dawn light out there beside the house, and I just happened to look over there, and there was this thing standing right directly under that light. But this had, his face looked kind of like a leather or something, you know? But its hair was, its arms was long, and it was tall, and it was covered with It looked like dark brown hair. Of course, it was night, but he was under that light. Of course, I screamed. And I said, hurry up and get them kids over here, Jackie. I said, there's something out there. Well, she got the kids over there, and I seen it several times after that. It was running down the road over a fence there by the barn, and it was, I would say, every bit of 8 foot tall.
Every bit of eight foot tall. That does sound scary. Okay, that's legitimately scary.
And they make a big deal about they have a dusk till dawn light, which I just thought that's vampires. They make a big deal. They show them setting it up in multiple things where they're like, because the family's being terrorized by this monster. So they put this dusk till dawn light that they mention a lot. But
did you notice it for that reason?
Mm-hmm. Did you notice the strange choice they made when she was describing the creature? Play the first soundboard clip, please.
His face looked kind of like a... leather or something.
Yeah, the word kind of was emphasized with the terror sound.
They hit that beat at a weird time too.
It was a very weird time.
It comes out of
time.
Nowhere. It's just like someone had a gong behind her real quick.
Looked kind of like a leather or something.
So next time you're about to describe something, make sure to put the impact point at the word kind of instead of the adjective, because I think if the sound was on the word leather. That would have been a lot spookier.
It's distracting because you can't even hear what it is unless you put it as a soundboard clip and listen to it five times.
His face looked kind of like a leather or something.
You're right. It is actually maybe more startling to put the sound effect where you don't expect it, and they keep us on our toes that way. You never know when the sound effect is going to come out.
I do really like Rosalie Jenkins, though. She reminds me of like a...
Miss Pulley.
Miss Pulley, or the lady said, went down, ran over there.
Like that. It went down, it went off like this.
The woman describing Nessie. So she's just another one that's kind of beloved.
She was about to say, when she was kind of describing the leather face, it sounded like she was going to say, his face looked kind of like a secret. I was expecting it to go right into the Miss Pulley quote, because her voice sounds very similar.
You know, they like to be kind of like a secret.
I thought that she was about to hit us with the classic,
A dirty gray turned into yellow.
Mm-hmm. But she didn't do it though. She went with brown.
So we've got yellow and brown, which we know what that combination is.
It's hard to tell. If it's under a dust till dawn light, you never know. There's another terrifying account though from Bart's brother Dean, who one night went to fetch his sisters from the porch. When this happens.
And I heard a bunch of limbs breaking, coming through the woods, like something coming through the woods, something large coming through the woods. And it kind of gave me the idea to try to scare them a little bit, you know. So I told them, I said, look, here comes this Bigfoot, y'all better come on. Come on, let's go in the house. Well, it didn't work. And all of a sudden, everything got real quiet. And I looked over to the edge of the woods, and he was standing right in a little gully, right outside of the woods, just standing there watching us. And I tried to holler out, but my vocal cords had then shrunk up. I ran in the house, and I had to pull on Mom, and I couldn't even speak. I was so scared.
Is that what happens when you can't scream? I'm genuinely asking. Your vocal cords shrink? Is that it?
They shrink up. Yeah, they shrivel up, and then they get really dry. It's like same thing as when it's really cold outside.
I've never heard of that.
No, me neither.
When you get like nervous and stuff, your vocal cords can kind of tense up and you can kind of squeak and that kind of stuff. I've heard of that happening, but
that's,
I don't
that's
know.
Scary.
Never yeah, happened that's to scary. Me. I get this louder when I'm scared.
People aren't doing that around a regular Bigfoot. But we're going to hear more from Brother Dean as he goes on about his encounter.
They said I was white as a sheet. Of course, I did end up getting the kids in, but it didn't bother anybody or the kids. It was just standing there watching them. About 8 or 9, maybe 10 foot tall. Large man, broad-shouldered, covered in long hair, kind of a reddish-brownish color. And I could see that it was, some of the hair was turning gray, like an older animal. You know, a grayish tint to it in places.
In the alley. You got so close, Rob. You almost got it there.
Yeah. I know. I thought it was coming, man.
Man, this is a different beast. Yeah. It does sound really scary. Just the idea, I mean, the leather face that the girl described earlier, Jenkins, I just love her name. Yeah, that sounds horrifying.